I was a young boy in Currituck County, which is on the coast of North Carolina, north coast of North Carolina. My brother and myself kind of got started by building rat pick guns. That's what the News Observer guy said, that we, and then we contracted to do a smokehouse. We always were building things, and for a neighbor, we before we could drive, we took our wagons behind their bicycles and contracted to build a farmer a smokehouse. And so from there, we moved with, you know, high school shop, building things, and finally the and we started building model automobiles for the Fisher Body Craftsman's contest, and won some state prizes, and in 1950 I won fourth in the nation with the model car competition. It's over there in the cabinet. You may want to get a shot of it before we finish. But so while we were the part of the process for that, I was in high school at the time, was to go to Detroit to General Motors, had all the regional winners, and we went to an island and had games and played and rode boats and what have you, but also there was a big banquet. And while we were there, there were dignitaries there, and I was talking to the president of MIT at the time, a guy named Compton, and I said, well, I need to know where I need to go to college. And he said, well, you want to go to NC State, it's one of the top universities in the country to study design. So I proceeded to go to NC State, talked to Dean Kamphaffner before I came, and told him I'd like to study products design. And he said, well, that'd be fine. He says, you come join us in 52, the first 2 years are the same. And then at the end of 2 years, you enroll in architecture, and we'll end of 2 years, we'll have the product design course, and you can move into that, and that'll work out fine. 2 years after I graduated in architecture, they had products design at the state. So they were a little delayed in getting it, but I'm happy with that, because first job was with the Corps of Engineers in San Francisco, and then moved from there to Italy to work in the Mediterranean Division, Corps of Engineers. Did projects like the missile base in Turkey, which housed the U-2, the hangar for the U-2 at the time. The hangar door was, specifications were very wide and not very tall, and I told the Air Force, I says, I think we're gonna knock the plane tail off this plane when we try to put a plane in here. They say, you know, you're okay, go ahead. I didn't know what I was designing the hangar for, so. But after the powers went down, was shot down, and the specifications were plain, were in the paper. I says, oh, that's what it was. Left Italy, came back, went to work in Portsmouth, Virginia for an architect, worked there 2 or 3 years, and then a cousin of mine was in Raleigh, asked me to come join him in Raymond Sawyer, architect here in Raleigh, and so I came in one-man office. About 6 months, we had done all the work there was to do, and so I ended up working for Leif Vallon in Cameron Village. And one of the projects that with my colleagues was the administration building for the state. At that time, it was the state office. We called it state office building. Of course, the initials for the project was SOB, so we all called it the SOB. And it's across from the Science Museum today. That's the five-story building on Jones Street, precast, marble-faced precast, kind of a neat building. We also did the federal building with one of Mr. Vallon, which was over on Newbern Avenue. And after a few years with him and I moved to with two other architect colleagues and started Envirotech, which was people would ask me, was I an environmentalist? And I said, yeah, of course I am. But I said that the word enviro is envelope. And tech is from tektos, which is master building in Greek. And so that was the building within the envelope was the definition, not the connotation of an environment has become the quality, not necessarily the content. So it doesn't mean it's good. It means it's what's in the envelope, but it's okay. We'll go along with that. From there, several years now, we've probably the most notable project we did was the soccer park in Cary. It's now called Wake Med, and we not only designed that, we promoted it to be funded over a several year period. And someone asked me one time, how long did it take design? I said, about 10 years. Because we were working on getting it funded and getting it done all that time. And so that's become the thing. And it's kind of interesting because you go back to look at where I started with things and products designed, the model automobile contest, and then moved to architecture. And I've become almost more of a planner than an architect over the years. I've served on the Raleigh Planning Commission, and I've always got my nose stuck into transit and that sort of thing. So it's kind of a transition. So I'm not unhappy that I didn't end up in the automobile industry in Los Angeles or Detroit or somewhere else. I'm happy here in Raleigh with what we've been able to do over the years. It's been a great experience. In 1959, I went to work for the Corps of Engineers. Linda worked in the same building. She worked for the Air Force while we were there. Our first daughter was born in Italy. And of course, the reason I wanted to go to Italy was the old and the new. The work of, when I was at school, architect engineer, Pierre Luigi Nervi, visited the school. There was another engineer from Ferretti, from Milano area. Actually, he was from Bergamo. And so I became interested in what was going on in Italy, new and old, the sports palaces and the automobile showroom in Turin, Torino, and the Pirelli building in Milano. So all of those buildings were very important to me in my process. And of course, I enjoyed looking at the Colosseum and all of what Florence had to offer, and Michelangelo and Leonardo da Vinci's things. And that was a great experience. In Currituck, where I grew up, is border. Virginia is a border, is the Norfolk area. It's right up in the northeastern corner. So when I came back, I ended up from Italy. I got a job in Portsmouth, which I worked there about 2.5 years. We did some schools and worked on a shopping center and several other dry cleaners and things, fairly routine projects, but it was good experience. And probably when you hear me, the little bit of the of Virginia, when I say about it, comes out a little bit of close to being from Virginia. So, but that's because of proximity, not literal. Okay, basically the current modernist movement, I think probably every movement has been contemporary or modernist when it started, but the current modernist movement has its beginning back in the Mies van der Rohe, basically form follows function, and the abandonment of the classical styles, that we gave up the copying of the columns and the arches from previous styles, and from Egyptian through the Roman and all of the historical styles, the Greek, there's all kind of classical pieces, the Ionic column, the Doric column. But the modernist movement was to take materials and use them more in a natural form based system, and a more efficient use of materials. And it was a lot of new materials, and things like the elevator and the extrusion of aluminum, and became a way to do things differently and make them. So the modernist movement is a much cleaner, much more bold form-giving architecture. It has gone through the process of some really great things with some of the great architects, Frank Lloyd Wright, many others, but there's also a lot of stuff that's not very good, and that has kind of faded and gone by the wayside, has not recognized, and so consequently, we're blessed in this area because of the School of Design, which started in 1948, to have the faculty and students of that era who have led the modernist movement. And I think George Smart has identified that the Research Triangle area, Central North Carolina, is maybe the third most modernist homes in the country. And I don't know how we stand worldwide, because the Scandinavian and the German have a lot, and I've never heard any comparison, but we having lived in Europe, we were able to see a lot of different things that we were able to associate with both the old and the new, and understand of how the classics work, the Gothic, the various forms of gardens and classical gardens and things, and they all have their qualities, but the modernist movement is a different thing with a lot more simplicity and design integrity in that respect, as far as not copying the classical forms. There's a small sports project in Holly Springs that they're working on getting a small baseball stadium and a small little soccer stadium and some tennis and things. I think there's some softball proposed. So the putting those together, it's almost more planning than architecture, but it's still a lot of fun. And I'm still very much interested in how our region is growing. I tell people that if we don't change some of our dependency on total automobile, that probably from Rock Hill, South Carolina to Fayetteville is going to be one of the world's largest suburban cities in the world. And at a point in time, it's going to become very difficult to get an efficient transit system when you do that. There's some transit issues that really need to be dealt with in terms of how we're growing. We started in the early 90s working on the Triangle Central Park, which was a sports complex, was the idea of Mr. Jim Goodman, who wanted to build a sports park that had all sorts of facilities in the center of the triangle. This piece of land at the airport. Well, it never quite got going, and when he announced the project, the Dean Dome just went great. And then they built the state arena, and then when it came time to do baseball, rather than going to the center of the triangle, Durham didn't want the Bulls to leave Durham, so the Durham Bulls Stadium got built in Durham, and several other facilities. And then one day, Mr. Goodman called me and said, "What are you doing one Saturday morning?" And I said, "Well, I'm working. I'm sitting here at my desk at the house working." And he said, "You want to ride over and look at my baseball stadium in Durham with me?" I said, "Sure." So he picked me up, took me over, and on the way back, he started going towards Cary. I said, "Well, where are we going?" He said, "I need to show you something." So he drove by the spot where the soccer park is now, and said, "Well, Cocoa Booth wants us to put a soccer park out here. Will it work?" I said, "Well, I need to get a few maps and get things." It was a piece of property owned by the state. And of course, a couple of days I called him. I said, "It sure worked like a charm." And so from that point, in about 10 years, we worked on getting it funded and getting it built, designed and built. And it really turned out to be, it was listed as one of the top 10 all soccer facilities in the country at one point in time. So we've had the NCAA women's or men Final Four every year but once since 2001.
Wow.
Either one or the other, except for one time, and they're coming back. So we're excited about that. And so and Cary is doing a great job with managing the facility now. So, but anyway, recently we've added seats. It was initially when the Carolina Courage played, they were the first team to play there. And so we ended up with about 7,000 seats, and this last edition brought it to 10,000 is what NCAA wanted, so that's what we got. It's very, very nice, very nice facility. You can see to the left the new grandstands, and so that was really a fun project. And WRAL started to move towards doing digital or high definition television. They were the first station in the country to do high definition, and of course they needed a lot of facilities, so we added a significant studio wing on the back of the existing building, and with all of the electronics and stuff, we it's kind of interesting because during the process there were actually some equipment that had not been UL Underwriters Laboratory UL approved. And so we kind of had to wait to install that after we had the inspection, final inspection. But it was a very interesting project in which we really worked with. And that project, the contractor was selected along with us as the architect to design and build and work with it the whole time, so that we didn't make construction mistakes or design mistakes or owner mistakes that weren't, so we had a pretty good vertical integration on that facility. The soccer project was a bid project, but we lucky and had a really good contractor on that. So that always helps to have a good contractor. And then the administration building, which preceded all of those, I was working for Mr. Vallon, and my brother and my, at that time, my future partner in Envirotech was working for Mr. Vallon, and the building was under design, and it wasn't doing real well in the office, so we kind of took over the design, and that's when we got to a point that we wanted to use precast panels, and they're marble faced. They put the marble, thin marble in the form, and then poured a concrete in to make a panel. And then you set that, erected those panels in series and put them on the building. It turned out to be a right nice building. And it's where we did the strips. We made drawings of one strip, made copies of that, and glued them together on board so we could get a picture of the whole building without having to draw it all, because it was before computers, so we had to get some special thinking on that one to get it done. And my brother and my colleague were very much involved in that. It was really, and it was probably the first real building. It was a first state of North Carolina, fully air conditioned, contemporary building, modernist building, and really was that they built. So it kind of set the pattern for future buildings. Model car was built, was my second car. Was my brother started, and we actually had, and we were living in Currituck County in the little community of Maple, and the lot of several state prizes. The first car I did, I won second in the state, and that was 1949. I think my brother started in 48. He's 3 years older than I am. And he, by the way, he's also an architect. So he's more of a painter and designer than he is. He never became a registered architect. I built the car in 1950, and it is a block of balsa wood that I carved out. And it has 28 coats of automobile lacquer, and when I got the basic form that I wanted carved out of the block of wood, I would then put a coat of gray sand and sealer on it and look for imperfections and sand it and fix it and sand it. And then 28 coats took to get it like I wanted it. And there was an article written about it. At that time, most of the kids who were building model automobiles were in more urban areas where they had the ability to like bumpers and hubcaps, they would do them in metal, and then they would take them somewhere and get them chrome plated so they looked like real things. I didn't have any facility like that. So the hubcaps are the little plug out of rolls of Scotch tape at the time that I painted aluminum. The bumpers are plywood. The windows are sheets of aluminum. The headlights are thimbles with a mop handle piece around them, little metal piece that went on the end of a mop handle. So it's very much improvised, and I think probably it was a good design, so I think, but I think all the judges liked the fact that I didn't have all of the fancy stuff, and Country Boy did good.
It's amazing.
So that kind of got me started down the design path. Thank you. I was a young boy in Currituck County, which is on the coast of North Carolina, north coast of North Carolina. My brother and myself kind of got started by building ratnik gums. That's what the News and Observer guy said, that we, and then we contracted to do a smokehouse. We always were building things, and for a neighbor, we before we could drive, we took our wagons behind their bicycles and contracted to build a farm or a smokehouse. And so from there, we moved with, you know, high school shop, building things, and finally the and we started building model automobiles for the Fisher Body Craftsman's contest, and won some state prizes, and in 1950 I won fourth in the nation with the model car competition. It's over there in the cabinet. You may want to get a shot of it before we finish. But so while we were part of the process for that, I was in high school at the time, was to go to Detroit. To General Motors had all the regional winners, and we went to an island and had games and played and rode boats and what have you, but also there was a big banquet. And while we were there, there were dignitaries there, and I was talking to the president of MIT at the time, a guy named Compton, and I said, well, I need to know where I need to go to college. And he said, well, you want to go to NC State, it's one of the top universities in the country to study design. So I proceeded to go to NC State, talked to Dean Kamphaefner before I came, and told him I'd like to study products design. And he said, well, that'd be fine. He says, you come join us in 52, the first 2 years are the same. And then at the end of 2 years, you enroll in architecture, and we'll end of 2 years, we'll have the product design course, and you can move into that, and it'll work out fine. 2 years after I graduated in architecture, they had products design at the state, so they were a little delayed in getting it, but I'm happy with that, because first job was with the Corps of Engineers in San Francisco, and then moved from there to Italy to work for in the Mediterranean Division, Corps of Engineers. We did projects like the missile base in Turkey, which housed the U-2, the hangar for the U-2 at the time. The hangar door was, specifications were very wide and not very tall, and I told the Air Force, I says, I think we're gonna knock the plane tail off this plane when we try to put a plane in here. They say, you know, you're okay, go ahead. I didn't know what I was designing the hangar for, so. But after the powers went down, was shot down, and the specifications for a plane were in the paper, I says, oh, that's what it was. Left Italy, came back, went to work in Portsmouth, Virginia, for an architect, worked there 2 or 3 years, and then a cousin of mine was in Raleigh, asked me to come join him in Raymond Sawyer, architect here in Raleigh, and so I came in one-man office. About 6 months, we had done all the work there was to do, and so I ended up working for Leif Allen in Cameron Village, and one of the projects that with my colleagues was the administration building for the state. At that time, it was the state office. We called it state office building. Of course, the initials for the project was SOB, so we all called it the SOB. And it's across from the Science Museum today. That's the five-story building on Jones Street, precast marble face precast, kind of a neat building. We also did the federal building with one of Mr. Vallon, which was over on Newbern Avenue. And after a few years with him, and I moved to with two other architect colleagues and started Envirotech, which was people would ask me was I an environmentalist, and I said, yeah, of course I am, but I said that the word enviro is envelope, and tech is from tektos, which is master building in Greek, and so it was, that was the building within the envelope was the definition, not the connotation of an environment has become the quality, not necessarily the content. So it doesn't mean it's good. It means it's the what's in the envelope, but it's okay. We'll go along with that. So from there, several years now, we've probably the most notable project we did was the soccer park in Cary. It's now called Wake Med, and we not only designed that, we promoted it to be funded over a several year period. And someone asked me one time, how long did it take to design? I said, about 10 years. Because we were working on getting it funded and getting it done all that time. And so that's become the thing. And it's kind of interesting because you go back to look at where I started with things and products designed, the model automobile contest, and then moved to architecture. And I've become almost more of a planner than an architect over the years. I've served on the Raleigh Planning Commission, and I've always got my nose stuck into transit and that sort of thing. So it's kind of a transition. So I'm not unhappy that I didn't end up in the automobile industry in Los Angeles or Detroit or somewhere else. I'm happy here in Raleigh with what we've been able to do over the years. It's been a great experience. In 1959, I went to work for the Corps of Engineers. Lina worked in the same building. She worked for the Air Force while we were there. Our first daughter was born in Italy, and of course the reason I wanted to go to Italy was the old and the new. The work when I was at school, the architect engineer Pier Luigi Nervi visited the school. There was another engineer from Ferretti from Milano area. Actually, he was from Bergamo, and so I became interested in what was going on in Italy, new and old. The sports palaces and the automobile showroom in Torino and the Pirelli building in Milano. So all of those buildings were very important to me in my process. And of course, I enjoyed looking at the Colosseum and all of what Florence had to offer, and Michelangelo and Leonardo da Vinci's things. And that was a great experience. In Currituck, where I grew up, is the Norfolk area. It's right up in the northeastern corner. So when I came back, I ended up from Italy. I got a job in Portsmouth, which I worked there about 2.5 years. We did some schools and worked on a shopping center and several other dry cleaners and things. Fairly routine projects, but it was good experience. And probably when you hear me, the little bit of the of Virginia when I say about it comes out a little bit of close to being from Virginia. So, but that because of proximity, not literal. Okay, basically the current modernist movement. I think probably every movement has been contemporary or modernist when it started, but the current modernist movement has its beginning back in the Mies van der Rohe, basically form follows function, and the abandonment of the classical styles, that we gave up the copying of the columns and the arches from previous styles, and from Egyptian through the Roman and all of the historical styles, the Greek, there's all kind of classical pieces, the Ionic column, the Doric column. But the modernist movement was to take materials and use them more in a natural form-based system and a more efficient use of materials. And there's a lot of new materials and things like the elevator and the extrusion of aluminum, and became a way to do things differently and make them. So the modernist movement is a much cleaner, much more bold form-giving architecture. It has gone through the process of some really great things with some of the great architects, Frank Lloyd Wright, many others, but there's also a lot of stuff that's not very good, and that has kind of faded and gone by the wayside, has not recognized, and so consequently, we're blessed in this area because of the School of Design, which started in 1948, to have the faculty and students of that era who have led the modernist movement. And I think George Smart has identified that the Research Triangle area, Central North Carolina, is maybe the third most modernist homes in the country. I don't know how we stand worldwide, because the Scandinavian and the German have a lot, and I've never heard any comparison, but we having lived in Europe, we were able to see a lot of different things that we were able to associate with both the old and the new, and understand of how the classics work, the Gothic, the